So hi everybody, I'm Esti. I have a master's degree in osteopathy. During my training, I also did 2 years degree in a pediatric osteopathy, and I work in a clinic for specifically for mothers and babies. So today I'm going to be talking a little bit about that. And I wanted to focus mainly with mothers on lower back pain, because I think that's the most common complaint mothers come up with during pregnancy. And there are so many other topics we could talk about, but it would probably take for tomorrow morning or something like that. So I had to narrow it down a little bit. So, during pregnancy, most of us, so up to 80% of us, suffer from back pain at some point during pregnancy. And we also think it's normal because we should have some sort of pain during pregnancy, but it doesn't have to be the case. And there are so many nice things we can do to manage the pregnancy and the symptoms from the pregnancy to make it more pleasant for you. So, what can osteopathy do for you? So osteopathic care for pre and postnatal women focuses on helping the body's structure. So that means the joints, spine, and the soft tissue structure, so muscles and ligaments, to cope with the demand of the pregnancy and after pregnancy. It helps to alleviate some of the pains and the problems associated with the change of the posture, weight bearing, and stretching of the various ligaments and tissues that supports the uterus. So it helps the body basically and the uterus for the labor and recovery after the delivery. And it doesn't matter, again, if you give birth naturally or to C-section, your body is going to go through a lot of stress, which is quite nice to have addressed. And osteopaths can help to manage these also existing spinal issues during the pregnancy, aiming to reduce the impact of the pregnancy has on the disc, ligaments, and muscular problems. So why? Sometimes it's nice to address this, as I said, but also because when you have hormonal changes during pregnancy, the body is much more adaptable, so the relief from the treatment is actually quite instant compared to sometimes when you go and see someone for back pain, it can take a while to actually feel that it's getting better, but often after treatment, as you're pregnant, you feel it straight away. And also, the treatment is giving a benefit for the baby as well. It's giving more space for the baby to freely rotate in the uterus, and it's, the baby can find more easier the optimal position for the labor and the birth. So the treatment will also prepare, again, I think we touched this topic many times today already, the pelvis and pelvic floor muscles to accommodate as naturally as possible for the labor. And also it is thought to that osteopathic care during the pregnancy is reducing the risk of injury, not only for the mother, but for the baby as well. And this means that if you give birth naturally, obviously you might tear, or there can be a lot of stress to your pelvic floor muscles, but also the baby has to push through those muscles, which can also be quite tough for the baby. So, my role as an osteopath for the mother is to support the mother's body during the pregnancy, and there are no medical interventions done or anything like that. And I will work in partnership with the midwife if it's needed. Okay, so what am I looking for? So the aim is to balance the mechanics of the spine, the viscera, and the pelvis to allow the pregnancy to develop naturally and evenly. And the common ligamentous pain during pregnancy is usually because the uterus is not able to expand laterally and evenly. So basically that's the main thing we would be addressing. And of course we know that the body is changing from the beginning to the end of the pregnancy. And it can be a great relief to address the pains and aches you will go through during that time. And basically there are 3 stages of the pregnancy as we know. And the first trimester, the main change is that your pelvis is going to slightly change position to allow for the uterus to start to grow, and that often creates actually some tightness at the lower and mid back. During the second trimester, you start to grow that breast tissue that I'll talk about. Even if it's only 1.5 kilos, it is a change, and it's going to pull your shoulders forward. It's going to increase the curvature at your neck and at your mid back, and that's gonna make you more prone for neck and shoulder related pain. And during the third trimester, it's the most physical time of the pregnancy, and often it's you start to feel pain at the hip and low back, and that's mainly because you really start to increase the curves, and your pelvis is really starting to prepare for the delivery. And often all these changes and the relaxing nature of osteopathy, people choose to see osteopathy, especially at the third trimester, standard care, which would be drugs and often exercise. And of course, drugs are not always the most popular choice when you're pregnant, not for you or for the baby. And treatment for osteopathy is safe. It is safe for sure, and it is safe for you and for the baby. All the techniques are specifically chosen for the patient in front of me, and it is depending on the case history you're giving me. There is no like a set of techniques I know and I'm going to do them for every pregnant woman I'm seeing, and there is no harm on any of them. But of course, if the patient is there, they're allowed to inform me at any point if they feel uncomfortable or anything, because I can work from any position. So we have to find just the best position for you. And also, it's found that osteopathic manipulative therapy is safe in the reduction of the pain and improves the function of the back during the third trimester compared to the usual obstetric care, which is again the front use and the exercise. And often people want to see the osteopath when they're entering the second trimester. This is mainly because it's advised, because during the first trimester, there's high risk of miscarriage, and we need to pass by that period first before we can start safely to treat you. And also, I think because at that point, you want to start to be a bit more comfortable, so you might want to have some treatment. Okay, so after birth, this is my nephew, so he is my anyway. So he's 3 months old. So what about the baby? So obviously we know that the pregnancy always doesn't go as planned, and many babies are born through C-section or tools are being used, so either 1 tooth or forceps, and this can lead to a tense neck and shoulders with the baby, and also it can alter the shape of the head. And also quick and prolonged delivery can lead to these tensions. Normally, they should resolve on its own as the babies don't breathe, cry, and yawn and things like that. But some babies are finding it a bit more difficult, and they cannot let go of these tensions. And often you notice this with your babies. They don't look really happy, it's difficult to sleep and things like that, and you start to worry about it too. So what can osteopathy do for babies? So cranial osteopathy. So cranial osteopaths, they are trained to treat the whole body. So this means the head as well, and and by the head I mean the skull and its joints and the membranes within the brain. And it's a really gentle approach. It's ideal for babies, especially who have had really traumatic births. And the aim is to gently to encourage the to release the stresses and tensions within the body. So there is no manipulations or anything being done. And the approach is really like pressure of the hands to find really the most comfortable position of the baby and encourage from there the body's self-healing mechanism and corrective capabilities. And the aim of all of this is really just to improve the body's function in a non-invasive way. And after, the babies really enjoy this, and you can really see it from your baby during the treatment. Okay, so the conditions commonly treated by osteopaths for babies. The digestive issues, difficulty breathing, brachycephaly, disturbed sleep, inability to relax, and irritability. And these are mainly because when you push through the birth canal, or if you have taken, if you had a C-section and you're actually kind of like sucked back up from there, it can create tension, especially at the head and at the base of the head. And that's where our nerves come out, and it can alter the function of the nervous system. And that will affect the functioning of the gut and things like that, which is actually quite important to address. Obviously, I'm aware that the gut is not completely mature when the baby is born, but you can see that for baby as well. That's why they might have the difficulty breathing, or they are having reflux or things like that, so quality kind of issues. And I think if there are many techniques we can do to help with that. And also, what is nice, I have so many techniques I can give you home to help your baby. So it's not only at the treatment room I'm aiming to. You have the same approach with your baby as I would do for the adults. So the treatment doesn't stop at the room, it has to continue when you get home. So yeah, that's